When Cinema Under the Stars opened in 1991, it never expected to have to shut down for a global pandemic.
I feel like suddenly life's pause button was hit, and I was sucked into this grade Z science fiction movie. I was rescued by Rod Serling, and now I find myself in a Twilight Zone.
Going to Cinema Under the Stars is like entering a different dimension. And anyone who's walked the red carpet to watch a movie there will recognize Ralph DeLauro as the one who rings the opening gong. The intimate outdoor venue closed in mid-March, but can now reopen with new rules in place to help prevent the spread of coronavirus. Most notable is that the zero-gravity recliners have been reduced in number and set in pairs at least 6 feet apart. Doug Yeagley owns the cinema and the adjoining Top Salon.
Probably the biggest challenge is just getting people to feel comfortable with the fact that we're an open-air venue that only does one show a night, so we have 24 hours to completely clean and sanitize and make sure that everything is in accordance with the law.
Everyone is required to wear a mask unless seated 6 feet apart. Couples, however, are allowed to sit next to each other.
I think people respect each other a lot more here. It's not like sometimes when you get in a mall and you get large herds of people, they're not necessarily mindful of other people as much as they are here.
The cinema reopens with an audience favorite, Raiders of the Lost Ark.
It's one that brings people together. And that's been Doug's vision from the very start of Cinema Under the Stars.
Now, people can come together with the proper social distancing to once again enjoy a movie as a shared community experience.
Cinema has always been, it always has been mass entertainment. I mean, that's how cinema works. It's projected on a big screen in the dark with an audience. That's where the magic happens.
Raiders of the Lost Ark plays through Sunday with Roman Holiday and Casablanca to follow. Beth Accomando, KPBS News.